Yeah, the film is blood story, set in picturesque surroundings of Coorg, setting of Coorg. Actually, this Coorg is a coffee county of India, a very vibrant place. Coorgis are very vibrant people, and they've got their own unique culture. And having that culture, I mean, using that culture, and I've built a story, woven a story around that culture and that nativity. And yet it's very entertaining. It's an Ejaculacy thriller. It's a thriller like Kahani, where you get entertained, you get a message, and also you get, you go out of the theater with a wholesome feeling, like achi film dekhi. So that kind of a film, so where logic is totally maintained and the suspense is awesome. So attempt is to give a very unique flavor to Bollywood, which it has not seen. So that's what Blood Story is all about.
So Blood Story, my first film obviously, and I'm very excited about it. And the fact that it's a suspense thriller makes it a more intriguing project to work with. And I would like to tell you that when I was listening to the story, he's a very good narrator, let me tell you. He got me convinced for this role, and how? Because he knows what he's talking, he's very clear about what he's saying. And the way he narrates, you can actually picturize everything in front of your eyes. So the story revolves around four lead characters, four main characters. It's a psychological suspense thriller which keeps an audience right on the edge of the seat throughout the movie. So every time you guess, oh, this is what's going to next happen next, this, and you're wrong. Every time I try to guess, I was wrong. So I just left my everything. I left my wits on the side. And I completely just listened to him. And I got so intrigued when I was listening to this story. And I thought it is a project to do. So I'm very excited about this project. And also the fact that it will be my debut film.
कौन सी ऐसी एक चीज थी जो आपको स्क्रिप्ट की तरफ अट्रैक्ट किया, या फिर क्या यूएसपी थी
इस फिल्म की? स्टोरी इसकी यूएसपी है, और जो हमारे कैरेक्टर्स हैं इस मूवी में, और जिस तरह के किरदार वो निभाने वाले हैं, जिस तरह की स्टोरीज उनके कैरेक्टर के इर्द गिर्द घूम रही है, वो भी मतलब इट्स लाइक एन अमालगमेशन ऑफ एवरीथिंग पुट टुगेदर दैट मेक्स इट अ वेरी गुड स्टोरी. एंड आई थिंक फॉर मी अ स्टोरी हैज़ टू बी गुड, द कैरेक्टर हैज़ टू बी गुड, and the director has to be good. And I think this movie offered me all of those above. So yeah.
Right. Lopa, ये आपकी पहली film है, और जो भी actress होती है अपनी love story से शुरुआत करती है या फिर horror film से, तो आपने किसी से suggestion लिया था first film के लिए, या फिर किसी से पूछा था कि मुझे किस तरह की film करनी चाहिए, अगर उस बारे में क्या thought process
था? हमारे पास बहुत सारी stories आई, बहुत सारी हमने scripts पढ़ी. We used to sit on every project and think if we should do it or not. But this film, I convinced, like I told my people that I want to do this because I like it personally. So I'm very intuitive that way. I'm very, मैं बहुत सारे decisions अपने हाथ से लेती हूँ, और बाद में अपने mind को लाती हूँ. यहाँ पे मेरा heart और मेरा mind दोनों sync में था जब मैंने project करने का decide किया. So yeah.
Mr. Narayan, proud to be associated with the project.
Yeah, definitely.
क्या कुछ तो सर one word.
Is the point.
So I wanted to give the good message to the society, you know, so making good films, and also we have a future plans to enter into the Hollywood also, and the story is very good and totally suspense, as director said and also Lopa said, and it's a different characters and also new culture for the, you know, Hollywood. And also Bollywood. We are planning to release this film in 36 countries. 1,200 screens also we are planning it. First film, you know. And also it's a very good, coming to the Bollywood from South. I'm very excited about this.
Okay. Lopa, crimes against women continuously increasing in India. How do you see this crimes increasing in India? Women's like rapes, child rapes increasing.
I think the law has to be really strict. The reasons why we have a lot of criminals is because the criminal thinks in his mind, I think, that until the law and the justice comes, it's going to take years and years for the judge to, like, because obviously that's the reason, the population is one of the reasons that we take a lot of time to give a judgment or any juristic or any, what do you call it?
Mm-hmm.
what's the right word to say?
Any verdict about
the criminal? We take a lot of time. So I think in the meanwhile, the criminal just fizzles out, and you know, he thinks that he'll flee. He'll just flee to some country. That's what is happening in our country. I think the law has to be really strict, like other countries. Like somebody who attempts a rape should be hanged to death. I think that it should be brutal. The punishments
should
be. And
another thing is, women should be respected. That should be taught to people. I mean, from the childhood, you know. Women are to be respected.
Yes,
girls are to be respected.
Our moral values, especially in the house where a boy child takes birth, the moral values to the child has to be really strong. He should be taught to respect a woman. He should be taught not a woman is not a plastic doll he'll play with, or you know, that should be the mentality of a guy when he's growing up. And the judgment and the verdicts that are taken on the criminals' punishment should be really firm, and it should be really rapidly taken without giving any chance for that criminal to just leave the country or think that he'll keep doing crimes and get away with it. That shouldn't be the thought. It should be really brutal for a rapist. The punishment should be that brutal that any other guy who even thinks of committing a rape should shiver with fear of the punishment. Even before committing it, that should be the brutality.
Yeah. We are planning for a January release, next January. So it's a start to finish project. So down south, we make films little real quick, you know, and more professional also. So we are planning to do it by January, mid-January.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks a lot.